through the steps on how to replace a dishwasher. So if you have an old existing one, first thing you'd want to do is look at the water supply. And in this case, we have solid copper. And I'm just going to change that to a flexible stainless steel supply line. It's going to make it much easier to move back and forth. And then take a look at your discharge pipe and the hose. See how it's connected in case you need parts at the hardware store. And then the first thing we're going to do is remove the bottom panel of the old dishwasher. And we're going to then test it with a tester just to make sure we have the electric off. I like these non-contact testers because you don't have to open the box and take a chance in touching live wires. So we'll go down, we'll turn off the breaker, we'll find which one operates that, and then we'll go to the next step. So I found the breaker that operates the electric to this, and I double checked it. There's no electric on. So I removed the cover to the box on the old dishwasher, and it exposes the hot, the black wire, and the neutral wire. And we're working here in the Chicagoland area, so we're using flexible metal conduit, which is grounded. So you're either going to have no ground if you're using BX like this, and it goes all the way back to the service panel and it's grounded, or you will have a ground wire that's going to be tied to this metal box. So now inside, what I'm going to do, there's a nut that holds this strain relief and that flexible metal conduit to this electrical box. So I'm just using a regular screwdriver, and I'm going to hit that nut and unscrew this. This will pull our electric away, and then I'm going to use a small pan, put it inside here, and using a small adjustable wrench, I shut off the water going to the dishwasher, then I'm going to loosen the nut on that supply line. So I disconnected the water supply, and now I'm going to disconnect the hose. The dishwasher, I just raised these feet a little bit. If you have a different height in your tile or wood, it's nice to pull these up a little bit because the next step, we're going to loosen the screws or any brackets that hold the top of the dishwasher in place. So now on this one, it just has two screws, so we'll just unscrew them, and that'll allow us to bring the whole unit out. Once you have the top bracket or screws loose, then you can just pull the whole unit up. I have the new supply line connected, and I connected it to the valve. What you're going to want to do is take a bucket, open that valve, and bleed out in case there's any debris or anything built up. You're going to let that run for a few seconds just till it runs clear, shut it back off, and then you'll be able to connect this to the new dishwasher. The next thing we want to do is connect the discharge hose to either a garbage disposal if you have one, or we're connecting it this time to a slip joint with a hose barb on it. So we're going to connect it to this, and then we're going to use a clamp to clamp it in place, and then make sure you read your instructions. Different models are different. This one wants to be about 20 inches high with this loop. So we have a hole cut into the top of the cabinet, which will set it at the correct height. Now that we have the new dishwasher, we pulled off the bottom panel so that it exposes everything to us, and now they have a chart for the back legs. Before we slide this into the opening, we're going to measure the distance between the floor and the bottom of the countertop, and we're going to adjust this. They're going to have a few different settings for you for the back legs. We want to set that first because when we slide it in, then we're going to level it by adjusting the front legs. Every dishwasher is going to be a little bit different. This one has a bracket that we're going to insert into a little slot here, and then we're going to use a pair of pliers, and we're going to bend these tabs up, and we're going to lock it in place, and this is going to allow us to screw up into the bottom of the countertop. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to connect our dishwasher fitting to our supply line. And dishwashers come with two different styles of a fitting. One is 3/8 IPS by 3/8 compression. The other one is 3/4 hose thread by 3/8 compression. And this is becoming more and more popular, the 3/4 hose. In fact, this dishwasher takes it, and it did not come with it. So make sure you check the instructions or ask where you purchase your dishwasher if you need a fitting, because in some cases you're going to have to pick one up. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take this fitting. I'm going to use a pair of pliers and a channel locks to hold the fitting. And I'm just going to snug this down first. And then I'm going to actually, a little tip that you can do is take a little tape and tape down your supply line, your discharge hose, and your electrical supply, and then we'll be able to slide the dishwasher right over the top of all three. Now we just push the dishwasher back in place, and we're going to connect all of the parts. Now we're going to take a level and we're going to adjust for plumb. So we're going to adjust our front legs. And I like these just inexpensive plastic levels with a magnet on it. And it just makes it very easy to do jobs like this. So now we'll just take our feet and we'll bring it up to its plumb, just like that. And then we'll set the level on the top. Now I'm going to take the water supply and I'm going to take this 3/4 inch hose thread and I'm going to connect this to the water inlet on the bottom. You want to hand tighten this and snug it down, and then you're going to use a pliers and do 1/4 inch at a time until it snugs up. You definitely don't want to over tighten this, and you want to make sure you hand thread it at first so you don't cross thread it. Next step is you're going to connect your hose, and ours just has a push fit fitting, so depending on the manufacturer it's going to be a little different, but this one just snaps into a rubber gasket. So for this dishwasher, it uses a hose clamp to hold that hose in place, and I really like these channel lock hose clamp pliers. And you can see these little indentations are designed to snap into this and grab it and hold it in place. So if you want a specialty tool, these channel locks just do a nice job for this type of repair. Since we're in the Chicago area, we have flexible metal conduit and we don't have a ground. That metal conduit's going to be grounded all the way back. We're going to twist our black wire to the black wire, the white to the white, and then put our cover back on. If you're using non-metallic cable, then you're going to want to make sure that you put the ground bare wire to the grounding screw inside the box. Everything's connected underneath. I'm just going to drill a couple pilot holes and connect these brackets to the bottom of the countertop. So the last thing, you'll just put your access panel on the bottom. You'll turn on the water and then turn on the electric. And those are the steps to replace a dishwasher.